So if you've seen the title and the thumbnail of this video, we got exciting news in regards to Burn the Witch and Bleach as a whole. So stick around as we talk about the recent leak that came out this morning from yours truly and some other people on Twitter that releases. And if you don't follow me over there, please go and check me out because that's where you'll hear the latest information in regards to anything Taikubo, Bleach, Burn the Witch or anything else related in that regard or anything that I care about in general. So hit that like and subscribe and let's get into the recent news, shall we? So as you all know, we've had some very interesting information in regards to the Bleach Animation Twitter account talking about the crew inside on the YouTube channel, on the Shonen Jump channel that I spoke about with Rebirth a few videos ago. Now, in regards to this new information that we spoke about with Bleach and Burn the Witch, it would seem that this segment on the Jump YouTube channel is going to be on the 28th of May, as you guys all know. But this one specifically, the one that we're going to be getting on the 28th specifically, is going to be about Bleach and not Burn the Witch, which is important because one of the leaks obviously that I leaked this morning, people are going to be already expecting that thing to drop on the 28th, which is not going to be the case. It's going to be a Bleach only stream. And from the Bleach website, I'm just going to give you a quick rundown because it doesn't really explain it on the Twitter account, so you have to go onto the Bleach website. And it basically says that a distribution program that provides information on the works of Kubo Toto, whose work continues to expand into animation and other media mixes. As the name Crew Be Inside suggests, this distribution program will allow viewers to become a part of the crew involved in Bleach and Burn the Witch and find out selective information about the works and information that has never been released before. The first distribution, we will bring you the latest information on the TV anime Bleach, the Thousand Year Blue War arc, the Farewell Tan. I think it's probably the separation, either way, translation diff. And then of course it gives a lot of information on the date and the time and who's going to be appearing, which is going to be Kubo, Shueisha's Jump editor, and of course Taguchi, which again me and Rebirth kind of explained. The contents, which it says, will be the TV anime Bleach Millennium Blood War arc, new information, and Bleach talk by the cast. So we expected kind of like the voice actors having to talk about maybe Core 1 or even coming into talking about Core 2, but we will be getting some new information, and that's either or a key visual or a preview, which again is really likely at this point. So it seems that there's going to be multiple segments, or this is going to be a multiple potential setting for programming of Bleach information coming down into the future using the Jump channel as that source. So the first episode, if we want to call it that, is going to be again specifically about Bleach and the Thousand Year Blood War specifically. Maybe not the Hell arc, maybe that will come in another segment, we don't really know. We'll see where it will go in general and see if we can nitpick and see any specific wording used in that. Of course, we will, of course, live react to it. So now that that's out the way, let's get into the point of this video, which is Burn the Witch. Some people know about it, some people don't. It's obviously not as popular as Bleach, we all know that, but as I've said in the previous videos with Rebirth, so if you haven't, go check that out, is that I do think it is in conjunction with the Bleach storyline. It is connected to the Bleach universe, and I feel like doing Burn the Witch first is really important into comparison to something like the Hell arc. Now this morning I was granted with some really cool information in regards to Burn the Witch, and that is that Burn the Witch season 2 or Burn the Witch 2, depending on what you really want to call it, because we still don't know whether it's going to be a movie format or whether it's going to be a series format, and I'll talk about the potential of that as well, but we do know that it is green lit at this point, which I know it hasn't been officially announced, but I'm very confident on the people that tell me this stuff, so it would seem to me that Burn the Witch season 2 has been green lit. Whether it's in production is another question. I would more so believe that it is, and it's going to follow the same path as what we had with the original Burn the Witch series. So with that being in mind, I do want to say I specified green lit just in case. I don't want to mess anything up, but that essentially means that it's been greenlit for a production, like all the executives have said yes. Whether it's been worked on right now or next year or the year after that, who knows? That is the question. So whether to keep your expectations on having something said soon, again, I don't know. But the positive thing about this is that, of course, with this crew be inside thing, is that we're probably definitely going to get an announcement. And some people still to this day don't know that the way Burn the Witch has been released, of course they can do an anime because, as I've said before, the manuscripts are already done. The story's already been done for a while. I've always said on streams and on videos, it's how they want to market it, how Shueisha really want to push Burn the Witch. And in this case, I think they want to follow the same route as they did last time, which was promote the manga and the movie simultaneously. It all depends as well on how big the manga is going to be as well. How many chapters has Kubo done? How much content is there? If there's only enough for a movie, then chances are it's probably just going to be another movie. And are we going to have Burn the Witch kind of released in movies? I mean, that seems to be the way it's going. Now, of course, I've always wanted the series. I love Studio Colorado. You know, it's a hit and miss with me. I've grown to like it, but I still do think it's too less detailed and too flat. But of course, we kind of sacrifice that for a lot of fluidity that Studio Colorado brings. So, you know, it's hit and miss. And I do enjoy both kind of aspects of that thought process. But granted, I would like to see Burn the Witch in a more like Toguchi style with the free layer of highlights. But again, that's just me. But yeah, that is unfortunately something I can't confirm at the moment, whether it's going to be a movie or a series. And I do think with how anime is going nowadays, especially with something like Boruto or something more like Dragon Ball, where they do the movies first and then they readapt them into a series with more context and stuff later on into a series, I do feel that may be a possibility in the future if Shueisha really want to go that route, or depending on how deep or heavy Kubo wants to go into Burn the Witch and how many chapters he wants to do. He might even just say, we're going to do a weekly series again, which he probably won't do, but still, the thought is nice. And especially if you're going to take a while to do the Hellverse as well, and if you are going to do Burn the Witch in conjunction with that same kind of timeline, you want kind of Hell Arc and Burn the Witch to kind of release somewhat simultaneously to some degree. So maybe the movie aspect would make more sense, because then you can have the manga and then Hellverse comes out with another manga, and then while Hellverse is coming out, then you have the Burn the Witch movie, and it almost seems like these two things are happening simultaneously. So again, I don't know, because this is quite new. Well, it's not new, but it's definitely different strategy that Shueisha is doing, and I think it's quite an exciting one nonetheless. And I mean, let's just get the Kuma out of me and just say, god damn, I can't wait to see Nini Spangle yet again, my tsundere Burn the Witch reverse London queen, because it's technically allowed because she's in a different universe and it's, you know, mirror dimension. So if there's a James, there's obviously a reverse James, and that reverse James can waifu Ruruko up. Anyway, we won't go into that, but I'm excited. I think, you know, this year is going to be some big things for Burn the Witch as well for Bleach, and I think, you know, Kubo is definitely working. I know a lot of you wanted, you know, the Hell Arc, and you want Burn the Witch, and you want more anime info, and you want, but it seems like we are getting so much this year, or even towards the end of the year, and I think we're going to go and get so much information in regards to Jump Festa later on. So, are you excited for a Burn the Witch return? Are you expecting a series? Are you expecting a movie? Even if it is a movie, do you like that it's going this direction? And, you know, who are you more excited to see? Are you excited to see Nini? You should be. Are you more excited to see Noelle? Some of you might be, because I know why. It's not because you like the character, let's be honest. And I'm excited to see Sullivan do something. Like, I think Sullivan is up there, of course. Got to see Bruno again, and I know all the fangirls love Bruno. We're going to see Balgo and Azushi again. And yeah, hopefully we get to see more dragons. I would love to do a video talking about the dragons. Actually, if anyone actually is interested on me talking about the dragons and my theory of what they can do, please tell me in the comment section down below, because personally speaking, I kind of want it to do well if I'm going to do that type of video. So, you know, I'm going to leave it off with that. I hope you enjoyed the news. Burn the Witch anime is in fact coming. It's greenlit. So now we just play the waiting game, and I'm excited. So yeah, I'll just leave it off at that. I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fun. I've been Hansen. As always, people, peace out.